Well, all right. Welcome to another segment of Trait on the Tape. Now, today we're going to be talking run game, okay? So now, let's just get into it. We're going to be talking about some inside zone runs and outside zone, but let's just drop an offense real quick. Here's our offensive line, quarterback, running backs to the left. So now we're going to go defensive end, defensive tackle, three technique, or one technique to the right, defensive end, and our two interior linebackers. Now, to me, this is a traditional nickel front. Now, when we're talking inside zone runs, all of those runs are just going to be between the tackles, okay? So that's what an inside zone run is going to happen. So now let's just talk about an example of it. You got the tackle to block the defensive end, combination block between guard and center, working up to the front side linebacker, then backside guard and tackle, or working combination block to the backside guard. So now the running back can hit front side or he can cut back. This is extremely important when we're talking inside zone runs, cutbacks. So now let's just change up the defensive front, all right? We're going to put a one technique on the backside, three technique on the front side, and still our two interior linebackers. So now let's just take a look at it. Now we're going to still get that combination block to that front side linebacker, and then now the backside guard will take the defensive tackle. Then now what happens between the backside tackle is that he can either do a sift block or he can do a cutoff. Now, this is extremely important when we're talking about inside zone runs because we're always trying to get the running back to the safety when we're talking run blocks. So here's an example of a sift where he can work his way up, or a cutoff where he's just going to cut off that defensive end and still try to get that running back to hit front side, or he can cut back. So now when we're talking about outside zone runs, now we can get down blocks and we're going to get pulls down block by the center. Pull that backside guard, okay? So then now that all that leaves now is the backside tackle is trying to work up to the backside linebacker. And of course, everything when we're talking about outside zone runs is about getting that running back to the outside. So now let's just change up our defensive front here, all right? So now we're going to put a three technique back on the backside, one technique defensive end, and then now we're just going to put in our two interior linebackers here, okay? So now here's where you'll start to see where now the offensive tackle will reach that defensive end. Then now you'll get that down block, and then you'll get those plays where you see Kelsey pulling out there, okay? Then now you get that combination block on the backside, trying to work to the backside linebacker. And again, it's all about getting that running back outside. That's all about outside zone runs. Now, we can add a tight end into the equation here, okay? So then now you'll see a down block by him, and then now you'll get that pull where you see a Lane Johnson getting out there in the field. Then you still get another down block here, and then now you'll see Kelsey. So these are the plays where you see Lane and Kelsey pulling at the same time. And then on the backside, again, you have that combination block working to the backside linebacker. And again, it's all about getting the running back outside, okay? So now let's talk about some zone read concepts. When talking about zone read concepts, it's all about reading that backside defensive end. The quarterback is taught to read that defensive end. If he comes crashing, then now the quarterback is going to pull the ball out of the running back's stomach, and then he's going to go. He's going to let that defensive end chase that running back, okay? So that's what we're reading when we're talking about zone reads. We're reading that backside defensive end. Now, teams that understand the zone read concepts, they will play that backside linebacker over the top to try to counteract that quarterback pulling the ball out, okay? So also, when it comes to some of these zone reads and we want to pass, we can also read that backside linebacker. If that backside linebacker comes crashing to the running back, then now what the quarterback will do is step back and throw a pass, okay? So he'll throw a pass over either to the left or right over his head. So this is what we're talking about when we get into some of the zone read concepts. Here's another concept that we get into, having numbers outside. So here we go. We have trips left. We have numbers, but they only have two DBs out there. The quarterback is taught, hey, if you have numbers out there, you know what? Abort the run. Pull that ball out of his stomach, and let's go ahead and throw the ball out there to the flat. So here we go again, just so you can see it. Trips left versus their two DBs. Safety is back. We have a run call, but hey, man, go ahead. Get the ball out there to the receiver, and then we'll just see what that receiver can do outside. You know, this is a very common concept when you're talking about zone reads, okay? So now, here's another example of it again. Here we go. Trips right. All right, they want to play off. Hey, a run was called. That's all right, cool. You want a playoff? You want to give us those numbers there? Just get the ball out of the quarterback hands. Let our receivers go out there and make some plays. All right, so now we're going to move on to the next player now. So right here, here we go. Outside zone. You see Kelce pull. You get a down block. Kelce pulls. Look at the effort by Kelce right now. Now, you know what I'm saying? Miles Sanders gets out there. And then now we're working outside zone run right there, okay? So now let's just take a look at this one right here. Here it is. The defensive end comes crashing. Jalen Hurts knows his rules. It's zone read. Defensive end comes crashing. Pull that ball out. Go get some yards, quarterback. All right, so here's a perfect example of an inside zone run, all right? Double combination blocks by both guard and center and backside guard and tackle. Running back's able to push it up inside. So now this right here is kind of like a draw type situation here, but hey, it works right here where, you know, you kind of let everybody come up field, you pass that, and then bam, you let the running back go ahead and hit them up the middle. All right, so here we go again. Another perfect example of an inside zone run. Double combination blocks, then bam, you pick your hole, and then now you're getting up field. That's all we need in the inside zone. All right, so now a lot of our offense was, you know, early in the game was all about Jalen Hurts just saying, all right, you know what? I don't like what I'm seeing. I'm just going to go ahead and make some plays with my legs. All right, so here we go again. Another example of a nice combination blocks. We're working inside zone right here. That's all you need. Get some positive yards out of it. So now we're going to move on to San Fran. So right here, we tried to pull Big Jordan. I don't understand why the running back did not follow Big Jordan here, all right? Why would you not follow the big fella, all right? So here we go again. Another inside zone run. You're trying to bounce it too much. I think right there, when you're talking inside zone, you have to press it. You can't sit back there and dance a little bit. You have to just go ahead and hit that hole. You got to go. But here we go. You're going to see positive yards, positive yards. All right, so here we go. It's always good when you have a quarterback that says, you know what? Hey, I don't like what's going on here. Let me go ahead and get on out of this pocket. All right, so right here on this inside zone here. Now, watch this. Ah, nice little move. Again, ah, let's get some. Get upfield. That's what I'm talking about. Nice inside zone. All right, so now I'm not a big fan of these reverse handoffs a little bit, but you know what? We made it work right here, all right? So back gets the ball. We're getting good push, but now positive yards, and that's all we're looking for out of the run. All right, so here we go. Now, here we go. A nice little example of another, again, inside zone run. Put your foot down. Get upfield, all right? So to me, I know a lot of people be like, all right, well, that was mid zone, or if it was, you know, outside zone, or if it's inside zone. To me, if there is a cutback built into it, it's inside zone run to me. So here we go. Now, there it is again. That defensive end comes crashing. Pull the ball. So here's another example of an outside zone where everybody's reach. Let the running back find his hole, okay? So that's all you want with this play right here. We're going to reach. Here we go again. Now, I had to show the TV copy of this, but here's a good example of it, all right? Everybody reach. Keep pushing. Let the running back find his hole for the touchdown. All right, so now we're moving on to Dallas here, all right? So now, yeah, you see everybody making their calls. We're all pointing at everybody. Hey, we're going to go to this guy. We got this. All right, here we go. You know what? Jalen goes through his reads, though. Reads that linebacker. Then now he reads the end. Now, boom. Go ahead, hit the receiver because we have numbers outside. Very common in the zone read concept. All right, so right here, we're going to have a play where we're going to be pulling everybody on the right. But 94 calls this play right here by playing upfield, shut that down, and then now everything just went haywire because, you know, you were kind of off with the read. All right, so here we go. Well, let's get back into it. Here we go. Look at this hole. Look at the inside zone. This is what we have. But it's all about hat placement there. The guard needs to make sure that he keeps his head on the inside because now that would have opened up that hole. Instead, it got closed up. So here we go again. Inside zone. You have to go ahead and make sure it's about getting that running back to the second level. That's what all of this is about, getting that running back to the safety, and we want to get him as clean as possible. So now, here we go. When you hit them with a couple inside zone, outside zones, then they start playing it differently, all right? So now that opens up some of these passes. So now look at it. Here we go. We're going to look for the handoff. Now I'm going to go through my reads. Bam, get the ball to the receiver. Now you have one of your faster guys out there in the open field making plays, and that's what this is all about. All right, so now we already explained it. That defensive end comes crashing, bam. All right, so now you pull the ball and you try to get as much as you can from the quarterback. All right, so, I mean, Jalen had a lot of yards running, but, man, just look at this right here. All right, he's in the pocket. Okay, we dancing around. We're going to turn around. We're going to spin. We're going to drop. All right, now let's get upfield. Let's get somewhere. Get somewhere. Get somewhere. Get somewhere. All right, you know what? Hey, no sack. Offensive line always loves that. All right, so now that reverse kind of handoff, I really wasn't too crazy about it because you're going to start seeing how teams are starting to play us for it. So here we go. Another example of the combination blocks, all right, inside zone. I would have liked to have seen Kelce get up to 54. And also if we could have gotten Dillard to sift to 53 here, all right. Again, watch that. Combination to 54, and then now we work a sift to 53. We probably have seen more yards in that particular run. I've never known a quiet down the crowd hand motion to work, but all right, good try. But here we go again. You try to pull it, all right, get the read, make your throw. That's all you want. This is all part of this zone read concept. All right, so since I've been giving you a whole lot of these zone runs, here we go. Nice little reverse. Hey, who is that? Who is that guy right there? Is that Rager? All right, so here we go. Now, you're always taught that if no one comes with the motion guy, hey, man, easy throw. All right, you forget to read. You call a run, but no one went with the motion. Get the ball out there to the receiver. All right, so here we go. Now, here is that reverse, but now we get a puller. Now, you know, the back is able to at least create some positive yards out of that. All right, so now here we go. Quarterback power. You know, when you have a quarterback that can run like this, why not pull out all the stops? Now, in this particular run right here, why not follow Kelce? Why not follow Kelce right out the gate? But all right, you know what, you bounce it, you try to make a little something out of it. But if you follow Kelce right out of the gate, I mean, it's a home run. But here we go. Now, you line up like this, hey, we're going to run it right up your throat, okay? So that was an easy read for us. So now let's move on to Carolina again. What you're starting to see right now is that this team is functioning really well. They're starting to find themselves in the inside zone run game, okay? Because that's when you have your guards are getting a lot of push. You're getting double combination blocks. And the running backs are starting to get a little bit better at finding it again. Inside zone runs. I mean, this is where you make your hay. And I know that Coach Stoutland spends a lot of time on combination blocks. All right, so here we go. We're getting those double combination blocks. Hey, you go through your read, bam. All right, so you know what? Hey, you got a penalty there, but you went through your read, and that's what you're supposed to do. All right, so now here we go again. A little mid zone, just because it wasn't all the way outside zone, but again, it worked. But here we go. You find your read. You're starting to see how those inside zone runs can affect the defense. All right, so now here we go. Again, you take your read. The defensive end comes crashing. You get up out of there again. Here we go. Look at it again. Nice combination blocks. Then now you can pull it. Now you get a touchdown off of it. Now, on this particular play right here, I only pulled this play for one reason and one reason only. All right, so now I want you guys to just look at Jordan Mailata here, and we're going to slow this down again, but just look at this interception, all right? So look at the effort right here, and then look at this hit. I mean, my God, look at the hit there. So now let's just take a look at it again. For those of you that need circles and arrows to keep up with what's going on my tapes, here we go, circle and arrow. So now look at Jordan Mailata here, all right? So now he ends up on the ground right here, all right? Find out, hey, somebody said Oski, interception, whatever, all right? Now he's in pursuit. Look at him now. Circle and arrow for those that need it, all right? So now he ends up on the ground again. He's on the ground again. So he ended up on the ground twice during the same play. Gets up. And then now look at this hit. I mean, my gosh, look at the effort. I think he likes when we throw interceptions. But all right, so here we go. We're moving on. Outside zone. So now this is kind of a mid-side zone, and mid-zone, outside zone. To me, if a cutback is built into it, it's considered the inside zone to me. But here we go. We're working it. Here we go. Combination block. Bam. That little reverse handoff. But like I said, you're going to see teams starting to play us for it. All right. So on this next play right here, you're going to see us run an outside zone, but with the quarterback. So here we go. We got two pullers. You got the running back as a lead blocker. You got a puller, and then you're just trying to get him upfield. All right. So now here we go. Look at this. Outside zone. You got Kelce. Yeah, he took whatever he could. Running back says, you know what? I'm just go ahead and put my foot down to try to get upfield. All right, so now here we go again. Let's just check it out. Now, you know, here's an inside zone run, but put your foot down. Oh my God, you missed a huge hole right here, but it's all good. Hey, you know, we're trying to make something happen here. Now, I love it when you can just have a back just punch it up in there. Nice little inside zone run, just keep it moving. All right, so now you go through your reads. Defensive end comes crashing, you pull it. All right, so now we're moving on to Detroit. What you're going to see now, all right, defensive end comes crashing, you pull it. But what you're going to see a lot of as we continue to move on through this tape, we're starting to develop as an inside zone run team, all right? Just because of our guard play, I believe, in that we can get those combination blocks. And again, hey, man, if Jalen doesn't like what he's seeing, hey, go ahead and go make some plays with your legs. There's nothing wrong with that. All right, so now here we go. We are playing to our strengths right now. And as this season continued to go on, you could see that we started leaning on those combination blocks between center and guard and backside guard and tackle and working it with the inside zone run. And when you go back and you say, hey, man, we would just set records. We had a record year when it came to the run game. It was because we were playing into our offensive line strengths. And that is having combination blocks up the middle and allowing our running backs to just go ahead and make some plays. Look at it again. We're out there just pounding guys and just getting that ball upfield. Here we go. Now, the quarterback does his job with the reads, but again, it's all about those combination blocks up the middle, getting push, and then we had the back stack and go ahead and stake it up inside. I think that that's one of the things that was key to us having such a successful year on the ground. Again, combination blocks. Look at these combination blocks. A little reverse handoff, not too crazy about it, but again, you're getting push, and then that's all we need. Get a little push. You give these running backs any type of push, and they will get up in there and make some positive yards for us. And then when those defensive ends come crashing, then now you have a quarterback that can get out there and make plays with his legs. It all plays into it. And if you line up like this, then of course, we're going to go ahead and just take what you give us. If you give us the middle of the field, we'll take it, no problem. But here we go again. Inside zone runs, nice combination blocks, nice finishing. That's what I'm talking about. Combination blocks, getting push, allowing our running backs to get out there and work the middle of the field. Again, here we go. Give me the ball. I need that ball. Give me the ball. Let's go. Here we go. You come crashing, then bam, now you got Jalen Hurts that's just going to take off out there. And then, you know, we're just making plays. But again, I've talked about it all night. I've been talking about it all day. Inside zone is the way. I'm up out of here.
And like that, he's gone.